So we're here in the Tower Theater, one of the centers of urban culture in Central Oregon. But if you get in your car and drive, or if you get on your bike and ride just a few miles in any direction, you'll encounter a different type of culture, one that's just as spectacular. So a cowboy rides into Prineville on rodeo day. He jumps off his horse, ties it up, runs around to its backside, lifts its tail, gives it a big kiss right where the sun doesn't shine. Justin Iverson is standing nearby, gives him a kind of weird look. Cowboy says, "I've got some powerful chapped lips right now." Justin says, "That heals him?" And the cowboy says, "Nope, but it keeps me from licking him." So, I am Rachel. I live, work, and play in Central Oregon, and I love rodeo. I love the people, I love the events, I love the photos that I take. The stock, one word about the stock. In rodeo, the animals are competitors. They're treated very well now these days, but there are still animal protection agencies and animal protection organizations who take issue with the sport of rodeo. Keep that in mind. The events, man versus man versus animal, both versus the clock. Rodeos require tough bodies and tougher minds, quick reactions and quicker recoveries, easy humor, and great humility. The rough stock is just like it sounds. It's the Bronx and the bulls of this talk. The first goal for the cowboy is to not crap his pants when he gets the first good look at his bull. If he does that, the idea is to stay on for 8 seconds and do it with style. On Bronx, you can ride with a saddle. That's called the saddle bronc competition. You can also ride without a saddle. That's called the pre-urban dictionary definition of bareback riding. Both of those you want to do again with style and grace, and you start with your heels up by the horse's shoulders. The timed events are just like they sound. They're the barrel racers, they're the steer wrestlers, they're the team and tie-down ropers. You're racing against the clock. The barrel racers sprint. The steer wrestlers are usually seen throwing their hat down on the ground once one of those little calves gets away from them. Team and tie-down roping, again, you're racing against the clock. It's the lariats come out, those little cute, innocent-looking calves. They get a head start. And they look little, but they're actually about twice the weight of most of those cowboys trying to rope them quickly. And now we get to the bulls. Bull riding is usually the last event during the rodeo because it's the most popular. Just like the bronc riders, the bull riders try to hold on for 8 seconds on the back of a really angry bull. They get bonus points for jazz hands. And it's usually about cowboy attitude. As much as I love those events, I love the people of rodeo more. It's what keeps me coming back and going to the different rodeos in our region. These two cuties here, the rodeo events themselves, they're great, but this type of thing is what makes it special. If we talk about rodeo people, we start with Chris Ledoux. He's a exactly bareback rider, champion, and songwriter. As he was traveling the circuit, he wrote great songs about the rodeo and life in the West, good songs, funny songs. The cowgirls, they're those barrel racers. They ride really fast horses. They sprint off the starting line. They wrap their horses around three barrels, trying not to knock them over, and then they sprint back across the finish line. They are the calm but nervy backbone of the rodeo. The cowboys, they dude themselves up just to look pretty in the rodeos and the parades. And they might do a little bit of other stuff like mucking out the stalls for the cowgirls and carrying the water for the winded horses. And that's Justin. That's really Justin. The clowns, J.J. Harrison is our local star. You'll see him at, I know, he's awesome, isn't he? He doesn't have to do much bullfighting anymore. The bullfighters and the pickup men help protect the riders. J.J. gets to play with pool noodles, Nerf footballs, assorted other props and jokes to keep us entertained during the down periods. The entertainers. In the years I've been watching rodeo in Central Oregon, I have seen a gladiator battle. I've seen a one-armed man wrangle two very large buffalo onto the top of a horse trailer. But my favorite is the four-horse Roman rider Sally Bishop. The queens. The queens add sparkle, smile, waves, really good horseback riding in the parades and the arenas. But the best part, they wear lots of lipstick, and the faces on the little boys and little girls when they pass by. Parades. What can I say about parades? I love a parade, but I don't really. But they're wonderfully tacky. They're great for the kids, and it's a good excuse to have a cold beer on a Saturday afternoon once you've sat through one. And so that brings us to the beer. You thought I forgot Jennifer Iverson, didn't you? So, there's beer at rodeos, but Central Oregon good beer people, we're talking Coors here. So, my advice is go for the whiskey. So thank you. I hope you get a chance to experience one of these in person this summer. We've got Sisters Rodeo and Crooked River Roundup in June, Deschutes County Rodeo in August, and the Palina Family Rodeo is Labor Day weekend. Good night.